rise. On behalf of Stephen and Megan and the rest of the family, thank you for coming to this momentous and holy occasion in their lives. We are all gathered here together in the sight of God to witness this union of Stephen and Megan in holy matrimony. It was God who created marriage and who said, "It is not good for man to be alone, and I will make a suitable helper for him." And it was God who instituted that the male and female come together and become one. And this is the relationship they are entering into before you and God today. Let's pray. Father, I'm so grateful that you have taught us what love is through your Son, Jesus Christ. That even in our own selfishness and our own pride, we can separate ourselves from you, but you took the initiative to mend a broken relationship that we broke with you, and you mended it through sending your Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for us. And so, Father, I pray that this time that we have together would be a reflection of your love for us, the reality of the sacrifice that you've made for us, so that way we can be in intimate relationship with you. And Father, I pray also as we commence in this ceremony that this covenant that Stephen and Megan are making, it would be in light of this truth and in light of how you have loved us. It's in your Son's name I pray. Amen. Who gives this beautiful bride away in holy matrimony?
Her mother and I.
So as God is the central person around which this covenant is being made today, it is fitting to hear from him according to his holy scripture in light of the promise that you're making, not just to each other, but your promise that you're really making to God and how to love one another. In Philippians chapter 2 says, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any fellowship with the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one spirit and purpose. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, but in humility consider each other better than yourselves. Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of one another. Your attitude should be the same as that of Christ Jesus, who, being in the very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but made himself nothing, taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on the cross. So here we see that God's vision for both of you is to be like-minded. Like-minded doesn't mean trying to convince Megan to have the same mind to you, and until she does, you won't be unified. And vice versa, it's not until you get him to be unified to you so you can be like-minded. The attitude of like-mindedness is to have the mindset of Jesus Christ. And Jesus himself said, a new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, all men will know that you are my disciples, i.e. that you're following me, you're becoming like me, if you love one another. And that is so crucial. That little couple of verses is so crucial to your relationship for the rest of your lives. It's a beautiful commandment, and it's a commandment that oftentimes is misunderstood. As Jesus says, a new command I give you, love one another. Which seems kind of odd, doesn't it? I mean, if somebody were to come in here and say, I have this new command, it's crazy. I mean, it's revolutionary. It's to love one another. I think we would all go, that doesn't seem new and that doesn't seem revolutionary. But it's scandalous because Jesus then defines what that means. It is new. It's new, maybe not. It's new in the sense of that way we often think of love. Because Jesus then defines what that love is, which is very different than the love of this world. He says, as what? As I have loved you. You know, and how has Christ loved us? Paul wrote in Romans, he said, you know, for God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Even in our selfishness, even in our pride, even in our laziness, all of those things, and all of our sins, Christ died for us. You know, when we think about it, you know, it says here, while we were still sinners, we were the ones who broke the relationship with God, right? But who was the one who mended the relationship that we broke? It was him. And the way that he mended it was amazing. Came into our world, humbled himself to a servant in obedience even to a criminal's death on the cross to pay the penalty of our own sins. Why did he do that? He did that because he wants both of you and all of us to be with him for all eternity. But he also teaches us in that how we are to love one another, this new command. You know, Paul says in Ephesians, husbands, love your wives as Christ has loved the church and gave himself up for her. Now, the question is has the church loved the Lord perfectly? Not even close. But has that stopped Christ's love for us? Not a chance. That's the covenant that you're making today, before God and to each other. That you're saying to her that I'm going to love you no matter what. Whether you love me or not, I'm going to love you because that's how Christ has loved me. And Megan, you're saying before God that, Stephen, I'm going to love you no matter what. It doesn't depend upon you. It depends upon the one who loves me the most, which is Jesus Christ. Now, that is an impossible thing. It is because, you know, you're going to get married and you know that you're marrying a couple of sinners, right? You're going to have days where you're going to be selfish and tired and all of that. And you're going to say, well, what about my needs? And that's a valid question because you have needs because God created you to be loved. But the only person who's ever going to be able to love you fully is the Lord Jesus Christ. Blaise Pascal said that we basically have a hole in our heart and the only thing that can fill it is an infinite and unchanging God. Because we're not infinite and we change all the time, even daily. That's the crux of your marriage. Jesus said it this way too. He said it in the same discussion that he had when he said, a new command I give you. This was the night before he was going to be crucified. He also said this to his disciples. And he wanted to understand this before he left. He said this, he said, apart from me, you can do nothing. This type of love, this unconditional love, no strings attached, give 100%, even if the other one's giving 0%, does not come from humanity and does not come from within us. It only comes from Christ. My encouragement to you for the rest of your life is to abide in the Lord, that let him fill your heart, and then through that, be the blessing to each other. And when you receive the love that you are receiving from one another, give praise to God because that's coming from God. And you've just been blessed that it's coming from one another. And so this is the covenant that you're making today. Are you ready to make this covenant? All right. So with that being said, before God Almighty, Stephen, do you take Megan to be your wedded wife? To love her with all of your heart, the way Christ has loved you and has given his life up for you, to seek God with all your heart and to allow him to use you to build up your bride and to serve her through sickness and health, through better and worse, through richer and poorer, till death do you part.
I do.
And Megan, before God Almighty, do you take Stephen to be your wedded husband, to love him with all of your heart the way Christ has loved you and has given his life up for you, to seek God with all your heart and to allow him to use you to build up your groom and to serve him through sickness and health, through better and worse, through richer and poorer, till death do you part?
I do.
And to all of you who have gathered here together to witness this covenant that they are making to each other, the covenant that Stephen and Megan have just made to one another, will you help them through encouragement and admonishment, as long as you know them, to uphold these vows that they so desire to keep, to be open and honest with them when you see them treating each other with indifference or being uncaring, so they can truly have the marriage that God desires for them to have, and that I know that Stephen and Megan desire to have. If you're willing to enter into this covenant with them, will you answer, "We will"?
We will.
May I have the rings, please? Thank you. All right. The rings that Megan and Stephen are exchanging today are symbols of their desire to love each other with an unending and unbroken commitment to each other. So, Stephen, would you place this ring on Megan's finger? And would you just hold it in place and repeat after me? I, Stephen.
I, Stephen.
Give you, Megan.
Give you, Megan.
This ring as a symbol.
This ring as a symbol.
Of my love.
Of my love.
And devotion to you.
And devotion to you.
I make this vow today.
I make this vow today.
To love you.
To love you.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
With all that I have.
With God's help.
With God's help.
Megan, would you please place this ring and hold it in place and repeat after me? I, Megan.
I, Megan.
Give you, Stephen.
Give you, Stephen.
This ring as a symbol.
This ring as a symbol.
Of my love and devotion to you.
As my love and devotion to you.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
To love you.
To love you.
With all that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
With God's help.
With God's help.
This moment, Megan and Stephen are going to seal their commitment together through communion with the Lord. To you. I thank you that their desire to come here is not just to have a pretty wedding, but to really say to you, I do, to love each other as deeply as you've loved them. And so, Father, I pray that through your Holy Spirit, that you would continue to strengthen their hearts and their minds for one another, that they would champion each other, that they would do this live together as a team in whatever journey that you take them. And as they go through all the difficulties and all the things of life, that they would do it in a way that brings them closer to each other and closer to you, Lord. It's in your Son's name I pray. Communion is a special bond between a believer in Christ, and not just an individual, but also together. Because in essence, what you're saying is this union that you're having together is not just with each other, but with Christ, one body, one blood for each other. And so, and for this reason, as it says in Genesis 2:24, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united with his wife, and they will become one flesh. As you and God have witnessed that Stephen and Megan have consented together in holy wedlock and have pledged their love and faithfulness to each other through their vows and giving and receiving of the rings, by the power invested in me before God in the state of Texas, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. As Jesus said, those that God has joined together, let no man separate. Heavenly Father, I pray blessing upon this newly wedded couple, that your Spirit would entwine them in the intimacy that you envision for both of them, Lord. I pray that their marriage would be one that brings great joy to each other and great blessing to many people. And Father, I pray that you would just continue to use them to be a light to the world that would share your love. And so, Father, I ask that you would continue to do your work in their lives, bonding them together. It is my prayer for them that 5 years from now, they'd love each other more. 10 years from now, they would love each other more. That 20 years from now, they would look back at this moment and say, wow, we love each other even more. And they would give you praise and glory for that. It's in your son's name I pray. Amen. Now, I am privileged to introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Nguyen. You may kiss your bride.